Welcome back to a new episode of LinuxMuster.net. My name is Stefan from OpenSchoolSolutions.org, and today we're going to talk about some Limbo command line tools that help you to manage your computers even faster. Okay, here we're logged in on our LinuxMuster server, and the first tool we want to check is Limbo SSH. For Limbo SSH and all the other command line tools to work, all of our client computers have to be booted to Limbo. So here we have our first client, R100PC01, and we want to log into this client with our Limbo SSH tool. Okie dokie, here we go. So we type in Limbo SSH, and then we just type in the host name of our computer, and we are logged in. So if we want to check our hard disk, we can see here have our four partitions, Ubuntu, Cache, Swap, and Data. And now there are several other tools we can use to work on this computer. And now that we are logged in on this client, we can use Limbo Wrapper to do several things. So, okay, here we go. So we have the Limbo Wrapper command, and then we can enter several other commands. Here we have a list of the commands like partition label format with the number, init cache, sync start, create a loop, upload a loop, reboot, hold, whatever. Okay, for example, if we want to partition or format our client, we can just enter Limbo Wrapper and then partition. And now we see that our client computer is partitioned. Okay, now just create the partitions, and we can also use format. And now it's formatting our partitions. We can only just use format because format will also partition our hard disk. Okay, let's wait until it's finished. Now we have a blank client, we have all the partitions and they're all formatted. And now we're using Limbo Wrapper to sync our client. And after sync, we put in the number of our operation system. And we have just one operation system on this client, so we put in one. If you have like dual boot system, you can put here one or two. And you can also do like combine the commands. So for example, if you want to sync the client and then reboot it afterwards, or if you want to shut it down, you can put halt, or if you want to start the first client operation system, you can use start one. So if we press, we type in sync one, it just syncs the client. Now it's going to download our image from the server, and this will take a while. So while this is syncing here the clients, let's go in a new root shell of our server, and here we will talk about some other commands. The second command I want to talk about with you is Limbo Remote. Limbo Remote is also a very helpful tool. It looks similar like our Limbo Wrapper command, but we can do several other things with this tool. Okay, let's try a command. So we can send a command to our computer with -c, and then for example a reboot, and we want to use our individual client. We use our second client now, -e R100PC02, and now it's sending the command to our second client. Okay, and if we check back here at our second client, we see it's now rebooting. Okay, so this is one way how you can use Limbo Remote. So you don't have to log into the client first. You can just send the command and then put in the client computer you want to change. You can also do what we just did on the other one. You can also like put sync one and then start one, and we can send this command to our second client. Okay, so we can use, you can see it here, -i to yeah, put a single IP or a host name or even a separate list, but we can also put a whole group or a room. For example, we want to sync a whole room. We can put the room R100, and then we state the command we want to do, -c, and then we want to sync all the computers in this room, and after syncing, we want to shut them down. Okay, and now if I press enter, all the computers in our room 100 will be synced, and after sync, they will be shut down. So another very helpful command is limremote-p, and after -p, we can put our command sync 1, and then after syncing, just start the computer, and we can specify a client or a room, and if we press this, then it says preparing onboot limbo task. So the next time we will boot limbo, it will sync and start our computers. So -p creates like a onboot limbo task, and so if we now restart one of our clients here, let's say PC02, let's go and reboot this. Okay, limbo is now rebooting. Okay, and now you can see limbo wrapper sync 1 is executed. So now it's syncing our client, and after syncing is done, it will boot our client. Okay, have a look at our first client. So sync is done, and we can also see that the post-sync is running, and so everything looks fine. So we can just reboot this client too. So we talked about limbo remote-c to create, like, to send commands directly to limbo. We talked about -p that creates like onboot limbo task. So next time limbo is started, it will finish this task. And there's another option here, -w, and it means it will wake our clients. So if they are connected to a LAN cable and wake on LAN is enabled, we can wake up our client computers, and then we can specify some time, for example, 60 seconds. And then after 60 seconds, we can send a command like sync the computer and start the computer. So after 60 seconds, this command sync 1 and start 1 will be sent to the clients, and -w will wake them up from over wake on LAN. You can specify any time here. You can use -c or you can use -p, depending how you want to send the commands. If you use -c, it will send over SSH. If you use -p, it will create an onboot limbo task, and so next time limbo is booted. So normally I use -w0 to wake up all the clients, and then it will create an onboot task, and next time limbo is started, it will just sync and start our computers. If I use -c and then a time, maybe 60 seconds, all the clients that are already in limbo will get the command, but sometimes clients are slower, and then they won't get the command. So I use normally 0 and -p to create online boot task, and then you can specify for sure the room or whatever individual clients to send these commands. So this is very helpful. You can also set up a cron job. So for example, you want to sync the computers every morning or every Monday morning, you can just put this in a cron job, and then every morning at a specific time, clients are wake up, synced and started, and are ready to use. Very helpful. Okay, so have a look at our second client. Second client, we just send an onboot task like sync and start, and if you go back, here we see it's booted. And we created this boot task for both of our clients. So when we check our first client here, you see it's just booting. And that's how it works. So today we talked about Limbo Remote and Limbo SSH, both very helpful tools to manage your computers in your school, because they help you to sync your computers, to reboot them, to start them, to wake them up from your server. So all you need to do is to log into your server, use Limbo Remote to wake up your clients, create an online Limbo boot task, sync and start, or whatever you want to do, format or partition them, specify the room or individual clients, and then yeah, Limbo will take care of the rest. This is very helpful and saves a lot of time. You can even use the scripts to create cron jobs. So if you want to have all your clients' computers synced at a specific time, no problem. Or if you just create a new image and want to deploy it to all the other computers, you can just use Limbo Remote-W and then wake them up and send your sync and start one command. That's it for today, and I'll see you in the next video. Please like this video and subscribe to our channel if you want to see more videos about open source software that you can use in your school.